Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture we are going to learn how to multiply the decimals. Okay, in previous lecture we have learned how to add and subtract the decimals, and now the next operation is multiplication. So we are going to learn how to multiply the decimal numbers. Okay, see practice 6.9. open your notebook and solve this exercise, practice in your notebook. Okay, multiply. First one, 12.96 by 6, means we have to multiply this decimal number by 6. So first let's arrange them in vertically. See, 12.96 multiply by 6. Okay, so as usual we have to multiply, as this is not decimal number. Okay, so as usual, how do we multiply our regular numbers? In that way only we have to multiply. We have to start from this side. We can take carry also. Nothing is different there. Okay. So 6 6s are 36. So 6 will come down. 3 will be carried. 54. 54 plus 3, 57. So 7 will come down. And 5 will be carried in the whole number part. Okay. Now see, there is decimal point before multiplying these two. There is decimal point, so that put that decimal point in the answer. Then 6 2's are 12. 12 plus 5, 17. 7 will come down, 1 will be carried. 6 1, the 6 plus 1, 7. Isn't it easy? Yeah. 77.76. Next. 1.325 by 8. Multiply 1.325 by 8. 1.325 into 8. Okay, let's do. 8 5s are 40. So 0 will come down, 4 will be carried. 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 4, 20. 20 means 0 will come down, 2 will be carried. 8 3s are 24 plus 2, 26. So 6 will come down, 2 will be carried. And decimal point here, 8 1s are 8 plus 2, 10. 10.6000. Okay. Next, third one, 124.72 by 7. That is 124.72. Multiply by 7. Everything is as usual. 7 2s are 14. 4 will come down, 1 will be carried. 7 7s are 49 plus 1, 50. So 0 will come down, 5 will be carried. Before multiplying 4, there is decimal point. So put decimal point in the answer. 7 4s are. What is 7 4s are? 28. Correct? 28 plus 5. 33. 3 will come down, 3 will be carried. 7 2s are 14 plus 3, 17. 1 will be carried. 7 1 are 7 and 1, 8. 873.04. Next, 34.123 by 30. So this 34.123, we have to multiply by 30. You must know table of 13. Next, there is table of 19 and 23. Okay? 13 3s are 39. So 9 will come down, 3 will be carried. 13 2s are 26. 26 plus 3, 29. 9 will come down, 2 will be carried. 13 1s are 13. 13 plus 2, 15. 5 will come down, 1 will be carried. Then there is decimal point. Now, 13 4s are, what is 13 4s are? 52. 52 plus 1, 53. 3 will come down, 5 will be carried. Okay? Now, 13 3s are 39 plus 5, 44. So, answer is 443.599. Got it? Pause this video, write these 4 examples in your notebook and remaining 2 examples practice by yourself. Okay, we'll solve next question. See next question. Find the following products. Okay. So see if you observe this seven example number 7 to 12. There is multiplication by 10, 100, and 1,000. Okay. Multiplication by 10, 100, and 1,000. See in the chapter multiplication, we have learned this type of example where we multiply the whole numbers by 10, 100, and 1,000. And in what we have done, we had done there, you know. Okay. Here also there is we are not going to directly multiply. We are going to use a shortcut. We are going to use the trick idea. Okay. So what is that? 3.7254 into 10. We are not going to multiply like in we have done in the first six questions. Okay. We are going to use trick. With that trick, you can find the answer within a fraction of minute. Okay. What is that trick? See, 3.7254 into 10. See, whenever there is multiplication by 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, that is the numbers with 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, likewise. What to do, you know? Multiplication by 10 here, correct? In 10, how many zeros are there? 1, 0. How to keep the trick in mind? See, there is multiplication and multiplication by 10. In 10, there is how many zero? 1, 0. So what to do? This number, no? First, this number, without writing decimal point, write as it is. Okay. Now see, there is 1, 0 in the 10. So this decimal point we shift. Let's shift the decimal point one place towards right side. One place towards right side. See, right side means this side. Okay, this is your right hand, correct? So right side means this side. Now there is 1 0 in 10. So this decimal point will be shifted here. Means after 7. One place toward right side. If there are 2 zeros, means like 100. Decimal point will shift it 2 places, means it will come after 2. If there are 3 zeros in the after 1, then decimal place will shift 3 places. 1, 2, 3 here after 5 will come. Understand? This is the shortcut. So as there is multiplication by 10 and in 10 there is only 1 0, the decimal point will be shifted 1 place toward right side. Okay? Towards right side in multiplication. And when there is division, it is shifted towards left side. That we will see while solving division problem practice. Okay. So now here there is multiplication by 10. So shift the decimal point 1 place towards right side. So now it will come after 7. Number say, just we have to shift the decimal point when there is multiplication by 10, 100, 1000. Okay. If this type of question is will be asked in the exam and you are multiplying as usual by 10, 4 is a 40, the 0 come down, 4 carry, 10, 5 is a 50, plus 4, 54. Not this way. I don't want solution in that way. I will give wrong though your answer is correct. Because when there is multiplication by 10, 100 or 1000, I expect answer directly using trick. Understand? Keep this thing in mind, because I have found in question paper so many students have multiplied step by step when there was multiplication by 10, 100 and 1000. So that is wrong. It will not be given full marks, now will not be given for such type of solution. Okay. So now 23.926 into 10, correct? First, as I told you, first write that number as it is without considering decimal points. Now there is multiplication by 10, so decimal point will shift towards right side 1 place. Okay, it's 1 0 is there, so it will come after 9 here. Then 163.72 into 100. Now see, 100, 2 zeros are there and there is multiplication. So there is multiplication, so decimal point will shift towards right side. And in 100 there are 2 zeros, so it will shift 2 places right side. So here 1, 2, here after 2 it will come. So 1, 6, 3, 7, 2 point, here it will come at the end. Okay, so at the end means we not need to write. It is at the end because after 2 there is no digit. If we put your decimal point, we can write 0, 0 here. but again its value is nothing, so as it is it will come at the end, so not need to write that. Understand? Okay, because every number when we write C, only 49 we write, no? Here is also decimal point, but where it is at the end. Okay, so 49.00, that is whole 49. So decimal point is not written. Similarly, here also decimal point is coming at the end, so not need to write that. 4.965, right here 4965. Multiply by 100. Okay, so multiply, so decimal point will be shifted towards right side and there is 100. Multiply by 100, in 100 there are two zeros. So decimal point will be shifted two places towards right side. Okay, so where it will come? After 6. Here. Got it? Next. 123.72 into 1000. Now see, there is multiplication by 1000 and 1000, there are 3 zeros, so the decimal point will shift 3 places towards right side. Let's write that number first, 1, 2, 3, 7, 2. Now where is decimal point? Here, after 3. And we have to shift it towards right side 3 places. But if you see towards right side, there are only 2 places, 7 and 2. And we have to shift after 3 places, so what to do? We can put 0 here. Okay? And decimal point will be shifted 3 places, means it will come after 0. So let's put 0 here and it will come at the end. So when decimal point come at the end, do we need to write that? No. So answer will be this. 1,23,720. Okay. Next. 15128. Decimal point is here. Multiplication by 1000. 3 zeros are there in 1000. So decimal point will be shifted 3 places towards right. Here. After 8 it will become. Okay. So here after 8 means do we need to write that? It is last number. 8 digit is in the last. So do we need to write decimal point here? No. Okay. So it will remain as it is. 15,128. Okay. So in this way we have to multiply by 10. Multiply the decimals by 10, 100 and 1000. Fine. I hope you have understood this trick. You have understood this idea. You have to go by same idea when there are examples. This type of examples. This why? Why with the idea? Because this saves our time. Within short time, you can find the answer. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.